I don't know, I just feel kind of spacey. Happy end of 2020, good riddance. I mean, happy holidays. It's the end of 2020, time to celebrate. So what do you say? Let's bake some cake and light some candles and let's have an origami party. First, the ingredients. This video is like 25 videos in one. It includes two tutorials, one, two, and 22 origami demos of models designed with my students, and one giveaway contest hidden somewhere in this video. You have to discover it for yourself in order to participate. The 22 demo models were all ideas that my students came up with at the beginning of each session. And together, with mostly me leading the way, we managed to design the models and film the demos in just one tutoring session. Even just this one candle, which you can skip right here for the tutorial, is like 10 models in one. It was designed with my student Sam. Here, have a look.
Here with Sam again. And we not only designed the Darth Maul lightsaber, we also designed a candle. And it flickers. It's a flicker candle. Ooh, look, I'm balancing it on my chin. Wow. I'm balancing it on two fingers. Whoa. Or it could also be a spoon. This could be like one of those 10-in-1 models.
Yeah.
It can be a shovel. It's a candle that appears. Ta-da. What else can it be?
It could be a catapult.
Yeah. I'm going to put a little piece of paper inside. It's a catapult. Ready? And fire. Oh, yeah. Good idea.
It's like a little thing.
Fire. So when you're on Zoom calls, you can fire things at the camera. You like that? Or it could be a tree. Oh, it's a tree like this. It can be the motorboat. I wonder if it could be a finger puppet. If you put your finger in here like this. Oh, it can be a claw. Yeah, I got a lot with this model.
So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to fold this flickering candle, this birthday cake, and how to put them together. And fold a whole bunch of candles. And if you don't want them to fall out, well, you can fold this dirtier cake, which really holds the candles in. And I have a tutorial for it on my variety channel. What? It's a variety channel. I can teach some origami on it. And special for my members, I have this elongated cake, which really holds the candles in place. I can't even blow them out. And to join as a member, here's the link. So as many of you know, I've been doing a lot of Zoom tutoring sessions during this pandemic. So for this giveaway contest, you found it, I'm going to give away a 1-hour Zoom tutoring session. But that's not all. The winner of this origami giveaway contest gets to choose which model from the 22 origami demos, which one model I'm going to develop and teach on this channel. So that's pretty special. And I'm hoping to do more giveaways like this to showcase the models we design during Zoom tutoring sessions. But I don't know how often I'll do it. I mean, this video is taking forever. Okay, rules for the giveaway. Let's keep it simple this time. Just click on the link in the description, fill out the Google form. I don't even care if you subscribe. I mean, I care, but it's not a requirement to participate in this giveaway. But you must only fill out the form once or else disqualified. Just kidding. I mean, I'm not kidding, but you know what I mean. Okay. On January 15th, I'll select the winner randomly using Google Randomizer. I'll announce the winner on my community tab, and if you win, you'll get an email from me with a link for where to schedule a free 1-hour tutoring session on my Calendly. And if you don't win, well, anytime you can hire me for tutoring sessions. You just go on my Calendly and select a time and date and pay for it, and boom, you got a session. I lead sessions of half hours or an hour or even 2 hours. And I lead birthday parties, and I make a cake, and I will sing happy birthday to you, and you will blow out the candles. If you want. So, here are the 22 demo models to choose from. And I just want to let you know I'm so grateful for all of your support, especially during this difficult time. Thank you, subscribers, members, Zoom students. You guys are the best. And I hope you enjoy these demos and tutorials. And if you just want to skip to the tutorials, skip to here. Okay, let's demo. So, without further ado, this tutoring session's compilation video, the theme is animals.
Here with Jake, and we just designed a new flicker. It's the proboscis monkey. It's the proboscis monkey from Borneo head flicker. Here's the nose, the eye, and the hair. Here it goes. Woo! Oh yeah! Yeah! Here with Savannah and Ryan, and we folded seahorse. Yeah. And it's a seahorse flicker.
And it hangs on glasses.
Yeah, it can hang on your glasses. Anything. Or your... It's finger trained. I have a seahorse finger now. It's a puppet.
Exactly.
Here with Neil, and we folded a bird with wings and legs, and it flaps.
Woohoo!
And it becomes a rocket. It's Calvin's 10th birthday, and we just designed a cat. Dun, da, da. And Calvin's cat has a hat. It's a cat hat. And it's also Flickr.
Flickr.
Everything's a Flickr. But I need to not do this until I hit the camera. Oh! And one more thing, it can be a finger puppet. And it's a cat with four legs. Dun, da, da. Yeah. Here with Ethan, and we designed a lobster. 8 legs, 2 pinchers, and a tail.
Whoosh.
Daniel and I just designed, what is it? Uh-oh, it's singing frogs.
Singing frogs.
Take two. Daniel and I designed singing frogs. La 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 la. It's the ribbit song. Ribbit 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 ribbit
ribbit.
Instead of ribbit, it's ribbit. Ribbit. Oh no, don't rip it. Don't rip it. Sri Balaji's sister designed this model. It is a snake, but it's actually whoosh, a snake with fangs. Well, I added the fangs, but there it is. Whoosh. Sally, Hayden, and I made this jumping snake with a split tongue and 2 eyes, and it jumps like this. Yeah, that jumps so good. You're sneaky. Yeah. Oh, got it that time. That was good. Hey. Yeah, cool. Awesome. Here with Wes, it's his birthday, and we just designed a new turtle. Dwing, 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 dwing. And it's a Flickr.
Thank you.
Thank you. Awesome. Here with Kainoa, and we just folded. It's a crane that's flying. There's the wings. And it can also be a mouth and a box, a bird box. And the bird box can spin. Here with Evan, and we folded a dragon with a chair, and it's also a finger puppet. Ta-da! Watch out, it's gonna bite you. Here with Neil, and we just folded a ramphoricious. It just came right out of the scene. It flies really well. There it is, good. Yeah. Here with Ethan, and we just folded a clapping dragon. It claps its legs and wings. Jaden and I just folded a, what is it?
A bull snake.
Bull snake. And it balances. Here with Rehan, and we designed an origami ant. 30 minutes. This is our first try. All of the legs. There it is. Whoosh. Yeah, awesome. Here with Griffin, it's his birthday, and we just designed a bass fish. These are our 2 attempts. Here with Oliver, and we just designed this crazy creature. It has a cat head, and it has turtle legs. So it's a ka-turtle. Ta-da! Yeah, that's good. Kairos, what did you fold?
I folded a bat.
It's a bat, a flapping bat. And I went with the original idea. It's a monkey with a mohawk.
Actually, the original idea was a man with a mohawk, but then we changed it to bearded dragon. Then I wanted to do bat because it looked a lot like a bat. And then he decided, okay, let's just do the man one.
Yeah, it ended up being a monkey with a mohawk. There's the monkey with the mohawk. Here with Lynn, and we just made a Hercules beetle, except that his turned into an octopus, and it's eating his finger.
Ow.
It's getting away! It's getting away! Ah! Oh, okay.
Wow.
And I just realized it also is a oscillation fidget spinner.
Spinning Hercules beetle. Mine's an octopus spinner.
Ta-da! Here with Felix, and we just designed
a carrot.
And the carrot has
a stem.
Wait, that's not a stem. That's an elephant's head. Whoa. Oh, there, it's a whole elephant. And the elephant's running away.
The elephant can stand because there's the flap in the middle. If you open the flap of it, it can stand.
It's standing on my hand. And it can be the cannonball carrot.
Oh yeah, I know that.
This is cannonball carrot number 2. Oh my. Uh-oh, I lost it. Cannonball carrot number 2.
Well, yeah, that kind of works.
It's a cannonball elephant. Whee! Cool. Noam and I just designed a flying hamster fidget spinner.
Wow.
Oh, it squirmed away. Ah, oh, there you are.
Hello, hamster. Back to the world. And you can also make it like...
Oh, it's a flying hamster too.
It's like a flying squirrel.
It's a hibernating hamster. It can flip around to the other side and go to sleep inside its burrito. And it's a paper airplane. Whoosh. Whoa.
And a little bit of a finger puppet.
It's a finger puppet. And it has a big mouth. It's Jaws. Dun, 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 dun. Wow! It's also a spinneroo.
Good thing I have a pencil right here.
Oscillation spinneroo. It's a flicker. Yeah. My lens is going to get so scratched. I'm doing this so much.
Ack!
Oh, whoa, it turned into a dog. Wow, that was neat. Right when you did that, it turned into your dog. And back to little cute hamster. Alex and I just made a pufferfish. Check it out. It's eating my finger. Ah!
Ow, that must hurt. Ah, he's eating mine too.
It's a ball flicker. Give me a kiss. That was awesome. All right.
That was really fun.
Congrats on our new model. I wouldn't have done this without you. You had the idea of the pufferfish, and so we did it. I mean, I know I was guiding us, but the original idea is a big part of it. So thank you.
You're welcome.
Update, I just designed a cake that can hold 25 candles. Hold on, now I just designed a cake that can hold 32 candles. So that's the one I'm going to teach you now. You can hardly see the cake. I'll teach this one special to my members. So in this tutorial, I'm first going to show you how to fold this chocolate cake, which is a modified water bomb. And then I'm going to show you how to fold this candle that flickers when you twirl it in your finger. And then I'm going to show you how to insert a whole bunch of candles in this cake, which is a strawberry cake. And so ready, set, here goes. Whoosh. So for the chocolate cake and four candles, I'm going to use 2 6-inch squares of kami. This is for the chocolate cake, and the orange square will be divided into 4 to make 4 candles. So let's do that now. So fold in half, make really sharp creases, and unfold, and fold in half in the other direction. Unfold, turn over. Now with this ridge like this, like a mountain, make a little tear right at the crease mark, there. And now holding the sides with the ridge pointing up, spread your hands apart, and the tear goes all the way down. And now do that with these 2 sheets. It's best to use the clean edge. This is the rough edge, and this is the clean edge. So make a little tear there, and pull apart. Okay, so we have our 4 squares, and let's make some chocolate cake. So, white side up, fold diagonally in half. Unfold, and fold in half in this direction. And now we're going to make the water bomb base. So, fold this corner to the top. Turn over and fold this corner to here. Open the big pocket, put your finger inside, and now push these 2 points together and flatten. And here we have the water bomb base. Now fold this front flap up like this. And now rotate, and we're going to fold this edge, this flap, to this edge. We're just going to make a little pinch mark right there. Make it sharp so you can see it. So it's aligned like that. And unfold, and now fold this flap to that pinch mark. Like that. And now fold this flap over this edge. and take out this flap. And now we're going to insert this flap into this pocket. But before we do that, I think it's easiest if you hold like this and just wrinkle it outward. Just loosen those folds by doing this. That way it'll be easier to insert it inside. So now that it's nice and loose, open this pocket and slide it in. Like that. And now let's repeat that on the other side. So turn over and rotate. And with the side that has two flaps on it, fold up like this, just like we did before. And rotate, make our little pinch mark. Fold to that pinch mark. Fold over the edge. Unfold this flap, and now holding it like this, loosen this fold. Just slide it back and forth. And now insert it into the pocket and slide it in. Like that. Now fold this flap to this side, turn over, and fold this flap to this side. And now we're ready to repeat on these two flaps. So fold up like this, and here we can just use this edge to guide us, so we don't need to make that pinch mark. So fold like that, and fold this corner to here, like that. Loosen the fold, just slide back and forth, nice and loose. Open the pocket, insert it into the pocket. And turn over and repeat one last time. All right, now fold the top down on these two points. And fold the bottom up on these two points. And unfold. And just so that we have neutral creases, let's turn over and repeat that step on this side. Try to go right on the crease. Okay, so we have genderless creases there and there. And now it's time to inflate. So hold it like this with the four flaps going in the four directions and blow into this hole. And voila, there's the chocolate cake. And it spins. Boing. Okay, time to fold some candles. Take one of your 3-inch squares, or whatever size you have. Let's begin white side up and fold in half. I find that it's best to fold so that we have the rough edges here and the smooth edges here from the tearing. So fold diagonally in half and unfold and fold to the crease. So I'm folding the smooth edge to the crease. And repeat. So I'm making a white candle with an orange flame. Now fold this flap over the edge. Unfold these two flaps and place them on top. And now fold, aligning the fold to this edge. Like that. And repeat. And unfold this flap. Turn over and fold this edge to the crease. And rotate and fold this flap up. Now when you do this, just try to make sure that this little triangle is the same size as this little triangle. So it's like that. And now fold this edge to the middle. And when you do that, try to hold the layers down so that they don't slide. And repeat on this side. All right, so it's like this. This is what it looks like on the other side. You might want to try to push these edges together a little bit. And turn back over. And now fold this flap behind. How much? What you want is for this to be a square. Just eyeball it, about like that. And now we're going to rabbit ear this long flap. So first, fold it over so that this edge aligns with this edge, and just pinch right there, and unfold, and now fold it so that this edge aligns with this edge, and just pinch it like that. Unfold, and now pinch the long flap in half. Pinch, 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 and pinch to make the rabbit ear. Like that. And now unfold this flap a little bit and open here and open here. So we have a boat, and it's a motorboat. That's the long motor. And this is the flickering candle. It flickers like this. So if you like it like this, you're done. So to light the candle, what you have to do is just bend it back like this and then press on the sides right here and boing, it comes back. It's very much like the lightsaber that I taught here. Boing. So bend it towards the open side. So it's like this. And then just press right here. Boing. And also, like the lightsaber, hold it on your chin like this, and then press. So you want to hide it from view like that. It's just on my chin, boing. Anyway, like that. But I want to show you how to make it more like this. So as you're flickering it, if you can press it in a little bit, so that it makes a fold, it goes like that and to there. So you push it in and it makes that fold right there. From the other side, you're just pushing it in like this. And then once it's in like that, then press right here. Just flatten it like that. And that just kind of centers it on the candle. It's still a little bit to the right, so I'm gonna just kind of push it, pull it so that it's centered like that. And now with these two corners, you can fold them inside. Where? You could fold them into this pocket right here. Like that, so it makes a nice sharp point there. And same on this side. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Now, if you want, you could pinch like this and just kind of bend that so it's flickering like this. And there's the 3D candle. But what I like to do, for some reason, is I like to push one side into the other. So it doesn't take up as much space, probably. So it goes in like that. And now, I like to just curve it back and forth like that. So it flickers. But, you know, however you want to shape it is fine. I like to shape the candle round. Well, unless I'm sticking 37 into a cake, in which case it's probably better flat. But to make a nicer looking candle, just press it like this. And that way, it's easier to make it look like it's flickering. Oh, and you can also twist it so it's a little bit more of a spiral. And that way, the flames will kind of go upwards a little bit, if you get it so that it's even. Yeah, play around with it. See if you can get a flickering candle. And now, time to put it into the chocolate cake. I just happened to fold a whole bunch of them, and I'm going to show you how to put them into the cake. So, let's see. I'll start with the one that we just did. So, this is easiest, just fold it over about like that. It doesn't really matter. The more you fold it over, the sturdier it will be in the cake, but the shorter the candle will be. So just fold it about like that, and now slide it into the white part, like that. And you can slide it from here to there. And then do that again. And I think it's best to have this part showing on the outside, and then the white part is on the inside. So I'm going to stick in another candle like this. And why not? Let's go for a third. So that really grabs them when they're all jammed in like that. So we have three here, and if we do that to all four sides, then we'll have 3 times 4 is 12. So now I'm going to show you how to put candles on the side of the cake. So how about sticking this candle right into the white pocket here? I'm going to have to open that pocket. Okay, the pocket is open, and now this goes in like this. And that's pretty sturdy right there. And now we can stick candles, how about right into this side, in the white part right here, into that pocket. And how about into this pocket, like that. And we can stick a few into that pocket. Yeah, so that'll do it. We have 5 candles in there. And then 3 on this side, so that's 8 here. And if you repeat that 3 more times, you'll end up with a cake like this. And for this cake, an update, I managed to fit 37 candles into the cake by stuffing more of them into each pocket. And this is the cake I'll teach the members. And to join as a member, click here. All right, and see you guys later. Whoosh! So there you have it. Hope you guys enjoyed folding this, and good luck on the Zoom tutoring sessions giveaway. Whoosh! Bye-bye.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Mark. Happy birthday to you. Whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. Hope you're having a good day and we miss you at unicycle basketball.
I don't know. I'm just feeling kind of spacey. I don't know what it is. I'm just feeling kind of spacey.